Hello, everybody, and welcome to this Isong Meadow matchup between the Isong Meadow Lady Spartans against the Minichog Lady Falcons. Minichog comes in at 4-9 with a conference record of 2-1, and Isong Meadow comes in at 2-11 with a conference record of 1-1. Number 15, Granger, comes up with the ball, passes it up to 4, gives it to number 20, 15-5. She goes up for shot and is fouled. Looks like it's going to be on Cafaro. Slepchuk is now going to be shooting 2. First one is no good. Key players to watch tonight are for EL, Meg Sharon. She has the most field goals with 3 points. And Anna Curley with most free throws made. And she puts it back up and in, number 20. It's stolen by Grono. Grono goes up and misses the layup. Rebounded by Hannah Kennedy. Madison Maurer comes up with the ball. Passes it up to number 30, who missed the 3. Looks like it's a violation. Granger comes up with the ball, passes it to Fourier. Back to Grono. Misses the shot. It's going to be off EL, Minichog ball. The sub. Cafaro comes in for number 23. Grono passes it to Granger. It's stolen. Sharon comes up with the ball. Pass it over to Whitehead. And is fouled. Looks like an offensive foul. Granger comes up with the ball. Pass it to Grono, back to Granger. Goes to Fourier. Tries to dribble inside. And is called for a double dribble, and it will be Isong Meadow ball. Isong Meadow trying to set up a play. Goes over to Cafaro, to Whitehead. Back to Maurer. Back to Whitehead, who shoots the 3. No good. And an effort by number 24, but Minichog prevails. Number 24 is fouled. As Fourier makes the first one. Madison Maurer is being subbed out by number 4. Misses the second one. Rebounded by Sharon. Comes up with the ball. And it looks like she traveled. Ranger. Number 5 comes up and is fouled. Looks like Cafaro got the foul. And she now has 2 fouls. Madison Maurer checks back in for Sharon as Roy makes the first. Oh, wait, no. Slepchuk makes the first free throw. And she makes the second one. Madison Maurer passed it to Whitehead. Trying to make a move. Passes it. And it's tied up. Looks like it's going to be Minichog ball. Great effort by Gagne on that play. Over to Demeta. Back to Slepchuk. Over to Granger. Back to Slepchuk. Back to Fourier. And it looks like it's going to be a foul on Whitehead. And Minichog is substituting. And now there's 2 fouls on Sharon. Oh, bad inbound play. Maurer goes for it, and she gets it. Passes it over to D'Alessio. And Gagne now has the ball. Passes it to Maurer. Tries to make a move, and she does. Passes it back to D'Alessio to Whitehead. Misses the layup. Rebounded by Fourier. Passes up to Granger. Granger up for the shot. Misses. Rebounded. And is fouled. Looks like it's going to be on Gagne. There are now 16 fouls for the Spartans. As she missed the first one. Very early scoring for this game to start with 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. 5-0 Minichog. Now it'll be 6-0 as she makes the second one. Goes over to Gagne, over to Whitehead. Tries to get inside, and it looks like it's going the other way. And it is a push off on Whitehead. And Issam Meadow would like a timeout. We'll take one too. We'll be back. We're back. And a slight correction. That last foul was not on Whitehead. It was on Cafaro. It will be Minichog's ball. Granger comes up with the ball. Goes to... Oh, it's stolen by D'Alessio, who passes it up to Maurer, who gets it back to Whitehead, who goes back to D'Alessio, misses the shot, rebounded by Minichog. Minichog coming up with the ball. Back to Granger. And it is tipped. And it will be Minichog ball as Sharon subs in for Whitehead. Oh, it is tipped by D'Alessio, but it will be still Minichog ball as Minichog subs. Yeah. Gets it to Granger over to number 24, who tries to get the shot and misses. And is rebounded by D'Alessio. It was Gagne that got the rebound. Goes over to Maurer. Back to D'Alessio. Back to Maurer. Tries to get up a shot. Rims out. And going for a tie-up. As it will be Spartan ball. Sharon will be the inbounder. As they get it to Gagne, who tries to shoot it, misses. And Minichok comes up with the rebound. They're coming up the court. And number 24 tries to get it and makes it. Making it 8-0 Minichok. D'Alessio. Pass it to Maurer. To Gagne. Back to D'Alessio, who goes up for a shot and makes it. First Spartan points of the game. Minichok comes up with Granger. Over to number 3. Back to Granger. Over to number 5. Tries to get inside and is stolen by Sharon, who's coming up with the ball. Gives it to Maurer. And it's rebounded by Minichok. To Bonavita. And is stolen. As Gagne slowly brings up the ball. Picked by Maurer. Back to Maurer. And bad pass by Maurer, and it's now Minichok ball coming up the court, and Gagne tries to get the ball, but it's now Minichok ball. And a substitute for the Spartans as Jessica Haywood comes in for, it looks like D'Alessio. To Bonavita, back to Granger, and it looks like it was tipped by a Spartan player. And it will be Spartan ball. Great defensive play by the Spartans. Sharon comes up with it. Tries to pass it up and is stolen by Minichok. Granger comes up with the ball. Goes up for a layup. Draw a foul and she gets it. So the foul beyond Sharon, I believe. She missed the first one. And Delaney Whitehead comes in for Sharon. 1:26 left in the first quarter. Minichok leads by 6. With one more free throw coming from Granger, who makes it. Madison Maurer looks for a teammate to pass to. Gets it to Kennedy, back to Maurer. Back to Gagne, who shoots and is fouled. Minichok is substituting and the Spartan substituting. Looks like Sharon is coming in for Gagne. Sharon inbounds the ball to Maurer. Back to Whitehead. Over to Maurer. Sharon shoots for 3. No good. Rebounded by Minichok. Coming up the court. Over to number 11. Back to Granger. Over to 5. To 3. Tries to shoot it and it's fouled. That foul will be on, I did not see that. Oh, that last foul was on Maurer, and the substitute for D'Alessio comes in for Haywood. second free throw was good. And a timeout is taken by East Long Meadows coach Tim Gary. We'll take one, too. 49 seconds to go in the second half. If you're just joining us, the score is 11-2 Minichog with 49 seconds to go in the first quarter. East Long Meadows has gotten off to a very slow start with many opportunities, but the ball has just not gotten down the net. Minichog has gotten their points from the charity stripe as well. Spartans already have 9 team fouls, and Minichog only has 1 foul. As Maurer goes up with the ball, passes to Sharon, who pops for 3 and makes it. 11-5. Granger. Number 3. And it's a travel. And it'll be East Long Meadows ball with 25 seconds to go with the shot clock turned off. The EL crowd tonight is very enthusiastic, supporting the Spartans. Over to Sharon. Over to D'Alessio. To Maurer. To Whitehead. Getting inside. And misses. Minichog rebounds. 14 seconds to go. Number 11 passes to Granger. Back to 11, who shoots. And it's rebounded by D'Alessio with 3 seconds to go, who throws it up. And is a travel with 1 second to go. As Minichog just runs out the clock to end the first quarter. We will be back for the second quarter of action of this game against the Minichog Falcons and the East Long Meadows Spartans.
Today's game is brought to you in part by the Real Estate Market Center, located on North Main Street in East Long Meadow. Whether you are thinking of buying or selling a home, please consider calling Michael Roby at the Real Estate Market Center.
This game is also brought to you by Holly's Auto Repair. Full-service repairs on foreign and domestic cars and complete auto service. That's Holly's Auto Repair, located on Shaker Road in East Long Meadow.
We welcome you back to the second quarter of action in this game against the Falcons and the Spartans. I'm Ian Clunan with John Rand on the camera. And Spartans have only gotten 2 field goals in tonight, with D'Alessio making 1 shot and Meg Sharon with the 3-pointer. Granger comes up with the ball, pass up to number 24, 23-5. Over 24, in, off. And it will be Minichog ball. And it is tied up. Madison Maurer gets it, and Meg Sharon's going up with the ball. And is trapped in the corner and is fouled. Looks like it's going to be on number 23 in Minichog. Speaking of the foul situation, the Spartans have gotten 8 team fouls in that first half, and Minichog only picking up 1, but now picking up their second. Meg Sharon looks for a teammate and gets it back to Sharon, who shoots it. And no good, and it's rebounded by Minichog, and Sharon tries to tip for the pass, but it's out of bounds. Minichog ball. Great effort by Sharon. Granger is trapped, and it's stolen by D'Alessio. Up by Whitehead, and it's fouled. Looks like this will be on number 5 of Minichog. And Minichog takes a timeout as East Long Meadows still down by 6. We welcome you back from a Minichog timeout with 7:22 to go in the second quarter. Whitehead at the free throw line. Misses the first one. Her second one makes it. Up to Granger. Number 23. And Whitehead steals it and is fouled by number 5, Ametichog. Great job of the Spartans drawing fouls, especially at this time. Great way to get to the free throw line and earn your points. Whitehead makes the first one. And she makes her second one. As Ametichog will sub. Up to Granger, is trapped. And it's travel, and it will be Spartan ball. Great defense by the Spartans. Maurer will be inbounding. Pass is over to Alessio. Back to Sharon, who hits for three. No good. And rebounded by Ametichog. Granger almost loses it from a pass from number 23. 23 gets the ball over to 24. Back to 33. Back to 20. Granger. With 7 seconds left, goes for three and misses. Granger gets the rebound. And she, it will be Spartan ball as she cannot control the ball. Gives it up to Sharon, who's dribbling up the court. As she will pass it to Whitehead. Gives it to Sharon, tries to get inside, and Maurer gets the ball. And is fouled by number 23, Ametichog, which is Carly Grono. Maurer misses the first one as Ametichog will sub. Number 20 in for number 5. As Maurer makes the second one. Very tight defense from the Spartans looking to press. 23 comes up with the ball. Grono over to Granger. Back to Fourier. Oh, and a bad pass. It is stolen by Sharon. And carries. It'll be Ametichog ball. Grono over to Granger. Over to Mitchell. And travel, and will be Spartan ball with 5:49 to go in the second quarter. Maurer looks to pass, and it is stolen by number 24, and who gets fouled. Looks like it's on Whitehead. She makes the first one. She makes the second one, making the lead 13-9. Maurer goes up with the ball, pass it to Whitehead, who goes for the shot off rim, and is rebounded by Ametichog, number 24, Fourier, over to 23, who misses it. Rebounded by Fourier. And it's battled for, and it looks like it will stay Ametichog ball. as Gagne substitute for Whitehead. Over to 23, back to Granger, who shoots it, tries to draw a foul, won't get it, and is rebounded by D'Alessio. Gagne dribbles up. Pass it over to Sharon, tries to get inside, won't get to it. Gets to Gagne, over to Kennedy, over to Maurer, who shoots it, won't get it, and it'll be Minichog ball. As Granger dribbles up the court, passes it. And number five out for three, misses. And number 33 rebounds and makes it. Over to Gagne. As Gagne is looking for a pass. As it over to Maurer. Back to Gagne, inside to Kennedy. As it will be Minichog ball from the pass that got out of bounds. Granger comes up with the ball. Back to 14, who shoots and misses as Gagne fights for the rebound and will get the rebound. She dribbles up court. Tries to draw a foul and she gets it. And that foul will be on number four. There's now 16 fouls for Minichog, picking up four fouls in this quarter. And Gagne makes the first one, as Whitehead will sub in for Madison Maurer. Spartans only down by 10 with 4:01 to go in the second quarter. Gagne makes her second one. Granger looks to pass and does. Gets to number 33, back 24, who goes up for shot, doesn't go in, and it will be Spartan ball. Gets it to Gagne, back to Haywood, over to Whitehead. Back to D'Alessio. Looks past the Haywood, who rims out. And Minichog gets rebound. Going back to number four, Minichog shoots up and does not make it. And D'Alessio comes up with the rebound. Looking to pass to Haywood, who has a nice spin move, but the shot does not fall in as Granger comes up with the rebound. Over to number 24. Back to four, looks, and it'll be a double dribble. As Kennedy and Maurer come in for, it looks like D'Alessio and Sharon. Haywood over to Gagne, over to Maurer, who is fouled. And it will now be 1-1. As Minichog picks up their 7th team foul of the quarter, of the half. Maurer misses, and it will be Minichog ball. And now it looks like Minichog is going to be shooting free throws here. She missed the first one. Roy trying to make it a 5-point lead for the Falcons. And misses. Rebounded by Kennedy. Over to Maurer. Over to Whitehead. Looks to pass. Gets to Kennedy. Over to Gagne. Back to Kennedy. Looks to shoot. And does not go in, but then rebounded. Haywood is fouled. Looks like it will be on number 15 in Minichog. As that will be their eighth team foul. Haywood misses the first one as Sharon will sub in for Whitehead. Her second one will miss. And rebounded by Minichog, Granger comes up with the ball. Over to number 4. Back to Granger. Over to number 20. Back to 14. Over to 33 in Minichog. Number 14 looks to pass and does to number 33, who goes inside and is fouled. It looks like this foul will be on Kennedy. And missed the first one as Zosio comes in for Haywood. Looks like the Spartan crowd is trying to distract the free throw shot. And she does not get distracted at all as she switches that one. Over to Sharon, who shoots and makes it. With 2 minutes to go in the half, and Spartans are only down by 3. Over to number 4. Bad pass will be back to Isung Meadow. And Minichog will sub. As it is a football pass to Maurer from Gagne, and is stolen by number 23 of Minichog, who comes up and passes back to number 23, and is blocked. What a block by D'Alessio. Number 5, Minichog, looks to pass, and is stolen by Madison Maurer, who comes up with the ball. 1:40 to go in the half. Down by 3. Over to Sharon, who gets it over to Kennedy and is fouled by number 33, Minichog. Looks like that will be Minichog's 9th team foul. Spartans will be in the bonus if they pick one more foul. As Kennedy makes the first one. As number 15 in Minichog subs for number 24. Kennedy's second shot hits rim. And in Minichog. And it will turn over by Minichog and it will be Spartan ball. Gagne passes it to Sharon, who loses it, and Minichog is called for a double dribble as it will be Spartan ball down in the corner. Gagne will be inbounding. Looks to D'Alessio, who dribbles and shoots and does not make it. And Minichog rebounds. Granger gets the rebound. It's coming up court. Over to 14 to Minichog, who hits off rim and misses. And Granger gets the rebound. And it's stolen by Maurer. Maurer goes up. And it looks like Maurer's going to pick up the foul. Looked like she kind of... Look, Minichog will have the ball. Pass it to Granger. Granger misses. Right. It looks like... And it looks like the coach of East Long Meadow has gotten a technical foul, or not, has gotten teed up, as Minichog will have a chance to get the shot. And she capitalizes on it, and it will now be a 3-point lead for Minichog as she shoots another. And she makes them. As Hannah Mooney comes in for Madison Maurer, who has four fouls. Madison Maurer has four fouls entering the second half. And Granger comes up with the ball with 52 seconds to go in the half. She tries to go under, and it will not get it, and is blocked by Kennedy again. Great defensive plays by the Spartans. Gagne comes up with the ball. Great screen by D'Alessio. Looks pass back to D'Alessio. And it looks like it was a push-off of Minichog. And it now, Esau Meadow was in the bonus as Minichog picks up their 10th team foul. D'Alessio missed the first one. And D'Alessio misses the second. Oh, and she steals it. And is fouled by number 5 of Minichog. And she will... D'Alessio will go to the line to shoot two. With 29 seconds to go with the shot clock turned off. D'Alessio misses the first one. Second one is no good as 23 Minichog gets the rebound. Looks to pass. And it will now be East Long Meadow ball as Minichog continues to turn over the ball. Over to Kennedy. Back to Sharon. Over to D'Alessio. 30 seconds. Over to Sharon, who looks to Gagne. 5 seconds. And is stolen by Minichog with 3 seconds to go. Look to get off a final shot, and they won't get it. As the second quarter comes to a close, we are heading into halftime with the Minichog Falcons leading by 4. The score, 18-14. We will be back.
Looking for the latest news in East Long Meadow? Tune into LCAT News for updates on what's happening inside town government, up-to-the-minute information on local events and breaking news. Check out LCAT 01028 on YouTube.com or tune in each night at 7 p.m. on channel 191. LCAT News update for all the news you need to know. And don't forget, you can watch our complete lineup of LCAT sports anytime on any device by watching LCAT's YouTube channel, LCAT 01028. Subscribe to our page to stay up to date with sports games, meetings, concerts, and town events. All available wherever you are, whenever you want. That's LCAT01028 at youtube.com. If you're a local business owner, you should consider supporting LCAT's coverage of sports here in East Long Meadow by becoming an underwriter of our very popular sports program. Choose from 3-month packages up to a full year and let our viewers know that you support our teams and LCAT's commitment to share their achievements within the East Long Meadow community. To learn more about how you can become an underwriter with surprisingly affordable introductory packages, contact Sports Director Jamie Rook at 413-525-4220.
As Blue comes up with the ball, and it will be a 5th and 6th grade matchup. Red against Blue. As it will be red ball. Looks like Lorraine Clodier is... Oh. Rebounded by Caitlin Dowd, who shoots, and it is rebounded by Blue. Over to Olivia Robb. Tries to look for a pass, and does. Gets to Olivia Robb, comes up with the ball, passes it. As Blue gets the rebound. Okay, got it. Rachel Robinson looking for a pass. Gets it to number 3. And Red will bring up the ball. Caitlin Dowd. Be out of bounds. As it will be blue ball. Over to Rachel Robinson. Goes into the corner, shoots, and misses. As Caitlin Dowd comes up with the ball, shoots. And it hits the rim as Blue's fighting for the ball. As it will be red ball. Burley comes up with the ball. Looks to shoot. No good. And rebounded. And up and in. Rebecca Mena with the shot. And it looks like Burley's going for the ball, as it will be blue ball. Parsons comes up with the ball. Looks to pass, and does. And it is stolen. And Blue rebounds. Rachel Robinson comes up with the ball. Looks to pass. And it's stolen. Goes up for the layup. No good. Goes up again And it is good. Rebecca Mena with another shot. Looks to pass, and it is stolen again. And it is stolen by Blue. Back and forth game. Oh, and it's kicked. Good luck, Blue's going for the ball. And it will be blue ball. Red ball, excuse me. Caitlin Dow comes up with the ball. Shoots. Doesn't get it. Caitlin Dow gets the rebound and gets it up and in. The red team getting a lot of inside shots as Blue comes up with the ball over to Lorraine Clotier and has some moves. Who shoots it? And misses, and is rebounded by Caitlin Dowd, who brings out the ball. And is passed to Ava Makara. And blue team comes up with it as Lorraine Clotier brings out the ball for the blue team. Looks to pass, and is stolen. Caitlin Down comes up with the ball. Who shoots? And misses, but number 13 gets the rebound. Gets it up again. And is controlled by the blue team. Looks to pass. Gets it to number 15. DeGrave. Mara looks to pass. Who shoots? No good. And the red team will get the rebound and gain control. Over to Caitlin Dowd, who shoots. No good, but rebounded by Caitlin Dowd. Rebounded by Delaney. It will be tied up. The Spartan faithful are deferring whether who got the ball on the jump as red ball gets it, shoots it back to Dowd, who banks it home. Great shots by Dowd as Clotier comes up with the ball. Looks the jump ball. It will be blue ball. Clotier will inbound.
Hey, Clue, Jay.
And it is stolen
Jay.
By Makara. And Dowd brings up the ball, passes, and number 13, no good. And number 13 fights with the ball on the red team, and Blue comes up with it. Clotier comes up, who misses as number 13 gets the rebound, gives it to Burley. Burley comes up with the ball, goes up for the layup. No good. Rebounded by number 14. No good. Oh, the jump ball. As it is a game over, as the red team prevails over the blue team. We'll be back for the second half action of the Minnetrog Falcons and the Eastside Meadow Spartans.
Today's game is brought to you in part by the Real Estate Market Center, located on North Main Street in East Long Meadow. Whether you are thinking of buying or selling a home, please consider calling Michael Roby at the Real Estate Market Center.
This game is also brought to you by Holly's Auto Repair. Full service repairs on foreign and domestic cars and complete auto service. That's Holly's Auto Repair, located on Shaker Road in East Long Meadow.
LCAT welcomes you back to second half action of the Minichog Falcons and the East Long Meadow Spartans game. I'm Ian Clunan alongside John Rand on the camera. It is 18-14 as second half gets underway. East Long Meadow Spartans are in foul trouble. We have three players that are in foul trouble. We have Madison Meyer with four fouls, who's on the court right now. We have Delaney Whitehead with three fouls. And we also have Cafaro with three fouls as well. As it will be East Long Meadow ball, or Minichog ball, excuse me. Over to Granger, over to 20, Minichog, over to 33, goes up with the layup. No good. Number five gets the rebound and is fouled. And then it looks like it will be on Whitehead, which, or as that will mean Madison Maurer's fifth and final foul of the game as she is out. As there will be a timeout taken by East Long Meadow. We'll take one as well. Be back in a flash.
Go, Hannah.
We're back as Madison Maurer has just fouled out. As Spartans are down by four. Over to Granger. Back to 33, who shoots and makes it. Olivia Mitchell with the inside shot. Whitehead brings out the ball. Looking to pass and gets it over to Sharon, who shoots it and makes it. Cutting the lead down to four. Granger comes up with the ball, passes it to number 20, Demeta, and it is out of bounds. Looks like it will be Minichog ball. Gets it over to number 23, Minichog. Grono. Over to Demeta. Down to Mitchell. Down to Demeta. Over 23, back to Granger, who shoots and is blocked. Great defense by Kennedy in this game so far. As it will be Minichog ball still. Over to number 5, 23, and Whitehead goes for steal, but Granger recovers as Mitchell goes for shot and it does not go in. As Sharon gets the ball and it's get tied up, and it will be Minichog ball. Demeta will be inbounding the ball. Great defense by the Spartans, making Minichog take a timeout. We will take one as well. We'll be back in a flash. We welcome you back to this basketball matchup between the Minichog Falcons and the Lady Spartans of East Long Meadow. As Spartans are down by four, as Minichog is leading 20-16 in the third quarter with 6:48 remaining. As Demeta is inbounding, gets over to Granger. Back to 23 of Minichog. Over to Granger. who tries to draw the foul and will not get it, and it will be Esau on the ball. Whitehead comes up with the ball. Pass it to Sharon. And she carries. That'll be a turnover, and Minitrog will receive the ball. Granger comes up with the ball. Pass it to number 20. Back to 24, Minitrog. As that was a late hit by Granger, it looks like. As that will be Granger's third foul. As Whitehead comes up with the ball. Whitehead tries to make a move and pass it to Cafaro. Back to Whitehead. To Cafaro. To Sharon. Tries to pass it to Cafaro. And she loses it, but it will stay with Esau Meadow. With 11 seconds on the shot clock. Cafaro over to Sharon, who tries to get it in, and she does. What a great shot by Meg Sharon. Great reverse layup. As Granger tries to pass it, gets it to number 20, Minitrog. And number 5, and it is stolen by D'Alessio. Over to Sharon, who goes for the layup. And is blocked by Minitrog. And as Minitrog substitutes. Sharon over to Cafaro. Back to Sharon for 3. Oh, no good. And it's rebounded by Minitrog. 23 comes up with the ball. Over to Granger. Granger misses as D'Alessio tries to get the ball, but number 23, Mitchell, gets the ball, and it will be an and one. As that will be 4 fouls on Meg Sharon as she is subbed out and replaced by Gagne. Mitchell is trying to capitalize on a 3-point play and capitalizes on it. As Whitehead brings up the ball, 5:10 to go in the third quarter. Spartans down by 5. Over to Gagne. Looking to pass, and she gets it to Whitehead, who misses, and Minitrog gets the rebound. Who tries, and she is fouled. It looks like that one's going to be on Cafaro, and that will be her 4th. 3 team fouls for the Spartans already in the third quarter. As number 24 makes the first one. And Jessica Haywood is subbing in for Cafaro. And he misses the second one as the Spartan crowd is getting into it. As it will be Minitrog ball. Whitehead playing some great defense as Mitchell gets the shot, reverse layup as Whitehead comes up with the ball. It's getting very highly contested, who gives up to Kennedy, who is fouled. She will shoot 2. Anna Curley. As Curley makes the first one. as Mooney comes in for Whitehead. Curley is trying to make it a 6-point game. And she does. And it looks like an invert and whistle by the referee as play will resume to Granger. To 23, Minichog back to Granger. To 24, Minichog. As that looks like a travel, and indeed it is. As it will be Spartan ball. As Meg Sharon will sub in for Curley. As Gagne comes up with the ball. She loses it but gets it back to Sharon, who tries to draw the foul. And it will be a jump ball, and it will stay with Spartan ball. Gagne over to Sharon, who passes it up. And then D'Alessio to Sharon, asks for it for three. No good. As Jessica Haywood gets the rebound. And Gagne dribbling. Tries to get inside. Loses it. And it will stay with East Long Meadow. As Whitehead subs in for Jessica Haywood. Sharon will be inbounding. Over to D'Alessio. Who makes it? What a great play. As it is now a 4-point deficit for the Spartans. With 3:40 to go in the third. Granger. Gives it to number 24, who shoots and makes the three. What a great shot by number 24 of Minichog. Making it 29-22. Whitehead brings up the ball. Over to Gagne, who shoots and misses, as it will be Minichog ball. And it looks like Coach Gary would like to use a timeout, and we will take one as well. Spartans down by 7. 9 points. We welcome you back. If you're just joining us, it is 29-22 Minichog. And for the Spartans, our leading scorer tonight is Meg Sharon with 9 points. As Granger comes up with the ball, looks to pass, and gets it to number 24. And it is, oh, and it looks like a foul is going to be on Delaney Whitehead. And if that's the case, and it is, it will be her fifth foul. Or fourth foul. Coach Gary is very confused on that call. As Minichog gets the ball. Over number 23. Over to 15. Back to Mitchell. 15. Granger. For three. No good. As it will stay with Minichog. Someone is subbing Cafaro in for Mooney. Mitchell over to Granger. Back to 24. To 23. Looks to shoot. To 24. No good. 24 gets her own rebound. Tries to get it back up. No good. And Curley comes up with a rebound and Granger tries to tie it up, and it will be a jump ball. As D'Alessio will sub in for Delaney Whitehead. Over to Granger. It's blocked. It stepped on. Looks like Isamara got the ball and then stepped on the line, as it will now be Minichog's ball. Over to Mitchell. Back to Granger. And it's stolen by D'Alessio. Over to Sharon. Sharon shoots and misses the three. Rebounded by number five, Minichog. Over to 23. It is blocked by Gagne. Over to D'Alessio. Makes shot as she draws the foul and will now be shooting two. The Spartans tonight have been playing very good defense and have been getting to the line, which is really benefiting them so far in this game. First of two from D'Alessio. She makes the first one as Minichog subs. As 13, 23 actually is subbing in for number 20. As D'Alessio makes her second. And Minichog on a breakaway as 24 connects on the shot as it is now a 7-point lead. Gagne comes up with the ball and is stripped but gets it right back. And over to Cafaro, looks the pass, gets it over to D'Alessio, over to Sharon. Loses it, but gets it right back. Gets it over to Gagne with 8 seconds to shoot. Over to Cafaro, who's got to throw it up, and makes it. Great shot by Cafaro. As Granger travels, as it will now be East Long Meadow ball. Sharon gives it to Gagne. D'Alessio. Tries to get it to Sharon and does. Curly. Over to Sharon for three. No good. Sharon gets for the ball. It is tied up. As it will be Spartan ball. Spartans only down by five with 1:17 remaining in the third. Over to Gagne. Back to Sharon. Over to Gagne. And is stolen by Granger. Granger passes to number 24, Minichog, and is deflected, but Minichog recovers at number 20. Banks home the three. As it is now an 8-point lead. Gagne hits it off Curly's shoe, and Minichog steals Granger over number 20, Minichog. Over to 33, Mitchell, who misses it, and Gagne gets the rebound. Gagne looking for a pass, or shoots. Passes it to Sharon, who loses it, as it still will be Spartan ball. With 19 seconds left on the shot clock, with 22 seconds to go in the third, Spartans down by eight. Gets it to D'Alessio. D'Alessio. Over to Cafaro, who shoots. Hits rim. As Cafaro gets a steal and tries to get it, and it will be Minichog ball. Great effort by Cafaro. 11 seconds to go. As Minichog tries to look for the last shot of the quarter. Over to Granger. Defended. Over to number five. Minichog shoots. And it rims in with 1 second to go. And that will bring us to the fourth quarter. As the Spartans are down by 10 to Minichog. We will be back for the fourth quarter action of this high school basketball matchup. We welcome you back to the fourth quarter of the Minichog Falcons and the Spartans basketball game, as the Spartans are down by 10 going into the fourth. 20 gets the ball. Over to number 5 of Minichog. Looks to pass, gets to Granger. At the top of the key, goes down. Over to 5, to 24, Minichog. To 20, to Mitchell. 8 seconds left as number 24 misses. And Gagne comes up with the rebound. Brings out the ball. Gets to Curley, who is fouled. And she will get to the line. Curley makes the first one as Whitehead subs in for Gagne. As Curley makes her second. Curley brings up the ball over to number Mitchell, who bobbles it but recovers. Over to 5 Mitchell. Back to Granger. With 15 to shoot. 24 to Granger. To 5 Mitchell, who rims out, and they're fighting for the ball. As it will be Esam out of ball. Cafaro looks to pass, gets it to Sharon, back to Cafaro. To Whitehead. To Sharon. Cafaro to D'Alessio. Gets inside, over to Whitehead and misses. And Minichog recovers and comes up the court. Number 20 gets the shot in. As it now becomes a 10-point lead again for Minichog. As Whitehead comes up, goes into the corner. As Curley gets in. As it is now an 8-point lead for Minichog. Granger. Trying to get inside. And is fouled by Curley. With 6:01 left, Spartans are trying to hang in there as Curley picks up her third foul. As Minichog misses the first one. As Haywood subs in for Whitehead. Granger misses the second. As Haywood comes up with the ball. Pass it to Cafaro. Over to D'Alessio. Is battered by number 5 Minichog and gets it to Granger. Another turnover for the Spartans. Mitchell is blocked by Curley. Great defensive blocks by Curley in this game. As Haywood goes to the bench for Whitehead. Granger down low to Mitchell, who shoots and misses and gets her own rebound. Back to number 24, who shoots for 3. No good. And she gets her own rebound. And number 20 shoots, misses. As it will stay with Minichog ball as it is deflected off of Curley. Esam Meadow will call a timeout. And we will take one too. We'll be back for the end of this game. 5:21 left to go in the game as the Spartans are down by 8 to Minichog. As Granger inbounds for Minichog. Looks to pass and gets it to Mitchell, who bobbles it but recovers. And gets it to number 24, who shoots and misses and is rebounded by D'Alessio. D'Alessio gets it and is stolen by Granger. Gets it to Mitchell. Back to Granger. Over to number 24. Back to 20, Minichog. To Mitchell. 15 to shoot. To 20. Back to 5. 9 to shoot. Back to Granger. 6 to shoot. And it's stolen by D'Alessio. And it's taken right back by number 24. And who shoots and misses as D'Alessio tips it to Whitehead. 4 minutes to go. Whitehead goes to the layup and misses. Just got out. As it will now be Minichog ball. As it looks like Minichog will call timeout. We'll take one as well. 4:20 to go in the game. Spartans down by 8. 4:20 to go left in this game against the Minichog Falcons and the East Amato Spartans. Granger looks to pass it in. It gets to number 24. Over to Granger. Back to number 5 of Minichog. To 20, who bobbles it, and it will be a turnover, and East Amato will recover. As Gagne is inbounding, looking to pass. And it is turnover for East Amato, as Minichog will receive. To Granger. To number 5, Granger. 20 a Minichog. Gets it to Mitchell, who is fouled. And it is on Cafaro, and it looks like that will be her 5th foul. Player after player for the Spartans tonight are all in foul trouble. As Mitchell will be at the free throw line to shoot 2 to extend the lead to 10. Their first one is no good. As she misses the second one. As 23 misses and is rebounded by D'Alessio. And a one-on-one situation with Sharon in number 23 as Sharon misses and she gets the rebound. She's trying to pass it out and it is a jump. And it looks like it will be with Minichog. Number 5 of Minichog brings up the ball. Granger gets the ball, who shoots and is fouled. This one will be on Whitehead, if I believe. And if that's the case, that will be 5 on her as well. See this? With 3 Spartans out with 5 fouls, with Cafaro is out with 5, Maurer is out with 5, and now we have Whitehead out with 5, which is a big blow for the Spartans if they want to get back into this game, as number 5 will be at the free throw line to shoot 2. Her first one is good. Her second one is good as well. As D'Alessio passes it to Gagne. Over to Haywood. Sharon tries to pass it to Curley, but it is stolen by Granger. Granger, pass it's 24 for three. No good. Rebounded by Sharon. Sharon tries to get past the defender of Minitrog, and it looks like she draws the foul. Haywood will inbound. Over to Sharon. And it's a jump ball. It will remain East Sacramento's ball. As Sharon gets the ball, over to D'Alessio. Oh, it rims out. And Minitrog will retain possession. Granger. Over 24. Back to 5. To Mitchell. Back to Granger. Over to 24, Minitrog. 23. 10 to shoot. Granger. Back to 5. Who shoots? And it's good. 12-point lead for the Falcons with 2:38 to go in the fourth. And double dribble on Gagne, as that will be another turnover for the Spartans. And they will call for a timeout. We'll take one as well. 2:34 left to go in this game as the Spartans are down by 12 to Minitrog. As Minitrog looks to inbound. She gets to 24. Over. It looks like Gagne is going to get the steal, and she does. Gagne for the shot. No good. As she tries to get the rebound, but number 24, Minitrog, beats it to it. As Granger gives it to 23, to 24, to 5 a minute shot. To Mitchell. Back to number 5, to Granger. 10 to shoot. Granger to number 5. 8 to shoot. And it is stolen by Jessica Haywood. As it looks like it's a foul on Minichog number 3. And it looks like that will be 5 fouls on number 3. Haywood inbounds. Gets it to Gagne. Over to Sharon, who shoots for 3. No good, as Granger gets the rebound. 1:45 to go in this game. To 23. To Mitchell. And it looks like the Minitrog turns it over, and the Spartans will get the ball back with 1:37 remaining. As Mitchell gets subbed out for number 12, Minitrog. Haywood gets it to Sharon. Over to Gagne. Over to Curley. Who draws the foul? As number 12 is shaken up. As it is 1-1 for the Spartans. Her first one is good, as she will receive another one. Trying to make it a 10-point game. Her second free throw rims out as number 12, Minitrog, gets the rebound. Ranger over to 23, Minichog. 24 to 20. Passes it. 23, Minichog shoots. No good. Granger is blocked. D'Alessio brings out the ball. Gives it to Gagne. Over to Haywood. Wide open. Makes a shot. Granger brings out the ball. To 23. Sharon will pick up the foul. Mooney will check in for Curley. As 23 is at the free throw line. As she makes first one of a 1-1. Her second attempt is good as well. 49 seconds to go. Sharon, who shoots for three, hits rim as Granger gets the ball. With 38 seconds to go, and it looks that the Spartans are going to lose this ball game to Minichog. Back to Granger. Granger is fouled. 18 seconds to go. And that one is going to be on Sharon. Granger misses the first one. Granger makes a second. Gagne. To Mooney. And it looks like a malfunction with the clock, as it will remain Spartan ball. Gagne over to Mooney. Gagne, 9 seconds. As D'Alessio misses the three, and Minichog will come away with the win in this ball game, as the Minichog Falcons defeat the Spartans 45-33. I'm Ian Clunan, along with John Rand on the camera. We'll see you next time.